Good evening. First tonight, the clean-up from Melbourne's violent Christmas storms is set to drag into the new year and run to tens of millions of dollars damage. Emergency crews are struggling to handle the damage from giant hailstones, wild wind squalls and a flash flood that wreaked havoc.
A 2-metre wall of water wiped out Christmas dinner for several Eltham families. With drains blocked by the earlier storms, an evening deluge sent a torrent raging through homes.
You couldn't do anything about it, you just watched the water flow.
The water came on top of wind and giant hail. Windscreens pierced and roofs shattered in the onslaught. Hurstbridge rail lines so badly damaged that trains beyond Macleod won't run until Wednesday. Emergency crews helped residents escape a retirement village overnight, and a family was caught out when a rising creek swamped their home.
The guys in the CFA tied themselves into a rope chain and worked their way to the front window, smashed it and got the kids out. Carried them out, then carried out my partner and my mum.
100 properties in Taylor's Hill were in the path of the ferocious storm.
This hailstorm was literally the size of golf balls.
The SES made 30 rescues and received 3,000 calls for help.
It will take us a number of days to clear that backlog of calls.
From dark clouds in the west, a tornado wreaked havoc.
All of a sudden, you couldn't hear yourself think. It was so loud, it was like machine gun fire.
Diane Wynn swam for her life over fences and carports after her car was submerged.
Let the tide float me over and they grabbed my hand and pulled me out of the water, thank goodness. So pretty scary at the time. It was terrifying.
Jenny and Nick Riccatelli were supposed to host a party today. Their plans washed out when water crashed through a window.
Couches were just still floating around.
All they can do now is hope they're covered by insurance.
I'm not kidding, it must have happened within a minute.
It's been a sleepless night for residents after a wall of water gathered pace from the top of the hill, running through about 20 properties, flattening fences and even moving cars.
It's expected repairs will cost tens of millions. Melanie Davies, 10 News.